Well, howdy folks, my name is Jarrah Foster Fell, also known as Jarrah Bean. I'm a content creator and a social media coach. I teach business owners and content creators how to master social media in order to grow their online presence. Since early 2020, I have fallen head over heels in love with a little platform that is taking social media by storm. It goes by the name of TikTok. TikTok is a freaking blast and feels like a breath of fresh air in the land of social media. In about 6 months, I was able to grow my account to over 500,000 followers. And so today I'm here to teach you everything that I have learned and to spill all of my secrets. So let's dive into TikTok hacks to grow your brand. So first, why should you pay attention to TikTok in general? Well, here are some stats for you. It is the number one downloaded app this year. 50% of users are over the age of 34, and in less than 18 months, the number of adult TikTok users has grown over 5.5 times. There's no doubt about it, TikTok is fun, it's weird, it's a little goofy, and there is space for every single niche. I have seen it all from the regular ones like makeup and marketing to more specific niches like houseplant pros, baby swimmer teachers, and mural artists. What I love is that unlike other social media platforms, the barrier to entry is low and the ability to be creative is quite high. But if we think about it also from a strategic business standpoint, things get even more exciting. Why? Well, let me tell you, TikTok is a marketing machine, all for free. Let's break it down. So it's incredible for brand awareness. TikTok's algorithm creates a much more level playing field than other platforms that allows your content to potentially be seen by tons and tons of people. You are not just limited because you don't have a lot of followers. It's incredible for building relationships with your ideal client. By sharing short form videos, you have the opportunity to share value in your field of expertise or your passion, and therefore build the know, like, trust factor within your community and potential clients or customers. It's incredible for generating new leads and making sales. When your valuable content gets in front of the right people, when you nurture the relationship with your community, and when you show up consistently, this builds your authority. Once that is established, you can strategically use the links in your bio, both social media links and the direct link, to drive people to your funnels, your courses, your email contact, products, etc. Content strategy for TikTok. Let's dive into content creation, and not just content creation, but also building your content strategy in a sustainable way. The goal here isn't just viral videos, though I can admit that part can be fun, but also brand awareness, relationship building, and community nurturing. But before we dive in, I want to make three things super duper clear. One, you do not have to do a single dance on TikTok if you don't want to. Two, you are 100% not too old to be on TikTok. There are grandmas and grandmas who are killing it on the talk. And three, you don't have to be funny or even overly creative in order to be successful on this app. So no excuses to let any of these excuses hold you back from creating on TikTok. All right, content creation. As the very first step, I want you to have these three foundational pieces locked in. Your niche, which is the subsection of the market you're in, your ideal client or your ideal follower so that you know exactly who you are creating content for. And number three, your content pillars, which are the main themes of your brand. Once those are solidified, let's talk about the two general types of content that you can create on TikTok: calendar content and evergreen content. Calendar content is timely content and is great for quick and perhaps even easy engagement. I see calendar content as videos that are only relevant for a short period of time, and they can be broken down into two categories. One, current events, topics, news, which is pretty self-explanatory, and two, trends. Trending content is essentially the pulse of TikTok. They are videos that millions, if not billions, of users on TikTok are putting out. A trend can mean a lot of things. A dance, a song that everyone is using with a very specific style of editing, a dialogue or a script that everyone follows to say to someone and then you film it, a certain type of video or editing transition, or a specific way that text appears on screen. Trending content is certainly fun, but my biggest piece of advice would be to only do trends that you can add an on-brand twist to. Make sure it's relevant to your audience and your ideal client or follower, and create your own unique spin on it. Next up, we have evergreen content. Evergreen content is more long-term content that is relevant now, in a month, in 6 months, and perhaps even beyond. These types of videos are great for long-term views, since videos on TikTok can have the potential for a much longer lifetime than a platform like Instagram. I see evergreen content broken down into two categories. First, we have educational, things like tutorials, like how to style this t-shirt or how to design a logo, and also list videos, like 3 ways to grow your following or 5 tips to feel more confident or a roundup of your favorite tools of things. Second, we have motivational content, like storytelling, sharing your personal story, giving advice, sharing an experience, a lesson, share a success and how it happened, or before and after, showing some sort of transformation. Okay, I know that is a lot of information and it may feel a little bit overwhelming. So here are 3 quick start evergreen content ideas for you. First, think about this. What are the top 10 questions you are constantly asked by clients, students, or followers? For example, a personal trainer may get asked about proper squat form or how to find the motivation to work out. Make a list of those individual questions and voila, those are your video ideas. Second, ask yourself, what are the top 10 questions someone asks you who wants to get to where you are today? For example, someone who may want to be a personal trainer may ask a personal trainer about how or where they got certified and how initially they got their experience. Make a list of those individual questions and there you go, those are your video ideas. Lastly, what is a topic you could talk about for 30 minutes with zero prep? Write that down, dissect it into smaller topics, and those are your post ideas. So what should you focus on the most? Calendar content or evergreen content? Though I think you should certainly do both, your focus should be more on evergreen content, especially if it teaches in some shape or form. TikTok is making a huge shift towards practical and educational content, so much so that there will soon be a Learn on TikTok feed in addition to the Following and For You feeds. So my biggest piece of advice when it comes to content creation and strategy is to create content with value. So my darlings, we have gone over the types of content that you can create. But what about once you have your video idea and you are just ready to create? Let's go over some of the best video creation practices to get more views, get more engagement, and of course, to connect with your audience. First, starting with length. You can create a video that is up to 60 seconds on TikTok. However, I would focus your energy on creating shorter videos in the 10 to 15 second range. This is because 2 important things in regards to the algorithm are retention, which is how long someone watches your video, and re-watch rate, if someone watches your video more than once. It's way more likely that someone will watch 15 seconds versus 60 seconds, and it's more likely that someone will re-watch a 15 second video versus a 60 second video. So keep it short and sweet. Let's chat about structure. There are 3 parts to this: the hook, the middle, and the CTA at the end. The hook. This is the very beginning of your video, like 1 to 3 seconds long. The goal here is to stop the scroll. You want to catch someone's attention so that they continue to watch your video instead of just swiping up to see what's next. You can create a successful hook in a few ways. The words that you say, for example, addressing a specific pain point, saying something polarizing, or stating the topic of your video. Inflection, perhaps it's how you say it. Also, motion. For example, I have found that videos, when I like run up to the camera in the first 3 seconds, are way more eye-catching than when I'm just standing there. Moving on to the middle. Here is where you provide value. If you're creating a 15-second video, this section will be around, let's say, 8 seconds long. Though what you're saying and presenting is super important, be sure that the way in which you present it is dynamic in order to keep people's attention. That can sound a little scary, but can be implemented in a simple way. Here are some ideas ranging from easy to a little bit more complex to keep things dynamic. You can have multiple clips edited together, even if it's just you talking to camera. You definitely want to make sure that all edits are tight, clean, and crisp. You can change up the angles that you're shooting at. You can change what you're doing or the environment that you're in. And you can also use sound effects to emphasize specific points. You can use video effects and you can use transitions. The end of your video is where you want to create a CTA, also known as a call to action. You can ask a question and have people comment. You can ask people to follow you for more tips. Ask people to find you on other platforms like YouTube or Instagram. You can direct people to the main link in your bio in order to subscribe to your newsletter. You can ask them to sign up for your webinar, join your Facebook group, download your freebie, purchase your product. The list goes on. Let's finish this video creation segment with some other best practices to keep in mind as you make your videos. Be sure to shoot with good or at very least decent lighting. Utilize the text feature that TikTok has to apply text to your videos. The most important piece of text to add is for the hook. Write out what you're saying or the topic of your video in those first few seconds. Even if you're speaking throughout the video, you may want to consider adding in text bubbles for those who are deaf or hard of hearing. You also want to be sure to keep your text within the safe zone, which means keeping it away from any of the outer edges, and also keep it mostly in the middle, and especially away from the very bottom where your captions and hashtags will end up covering it. Lastly, in terms of text, editing text on TikTok can kind of be finicky, but it really does matter in terms of creating a polished end result. So be sure to spend the extra time to get it just right. You want to keep filters minimal. I'm personally not a big fan of the filters on TikTok, and I don't really enjoy viewing videos where it's obvious that a filter has been applied. In that same thought, keep effects minimal as well, or maybe just don't use them at all. You also want to avoid at all costs starting your videos with things like, "Hey guys, what's up? Just popping on here." These function pretty much as the opposite of a compelling hook. Using trending sounds on your evergreen content is a great way to potentially be boosted in the algorithm. If you choose to go this route, just be sure that you decrease the volume of the added sound so that it doesn't overpower your original sound. You can also think of a series that you continually create content around in order to create a reason for your followers to come back to your page. For example, Motivation Mondays or Mental Health Tip of the Day. Be sure to add a cover to your video with text before pushing it live. This helps to create a curated page so that when someone comes to your profile, they can get a quick preview into what each video is all about, therefore enticing them to click and view compared to if there was just no cover photo and no text at all. Okay, so you have created and posted your video and you're sitting there with your fingers crossed that you get on the For You page, aka the FYP. But let's back up for a second and talk about what the For You page is, just so that we're super duper clear. The FYP is the backbone of TikTok. It's the main feed that everyone browses, but every single FYP is different because TikTok curates what you see there specifically for you. The more that you interact with certain types of content, liking, commenting, sharing, the view time, clicking into a profile, the more TikTok gets to know you and will continue to show you content within that same theme. What I love about the FYP is that it's mostly full of people you do not follow. It's kind of the opposite of Instagram in that way. On Instagram, we spend most of our time scrolling through our feed of people that we have chosen to follow, and usually a small amount of time on our Explore page. However, on TikTok, people spend the bulk of their time on the FYP, which shows us creators that we don't necessarily follow, both big and small. And then usually we spend not a ton of time on our follow feed, which is the people that we've chosen to follow on TikTok. This is one of the reasons why TikTok is so great. You don't need tons of followers in order to reach tons of people. The algorithm and the way that the FYP works levels the playing field for smaller creators. For a while, there was a lot of speculation on how exactly the For You page recommends videos to its users. And the amazing thing is TikTok actually released information on how exactly it all works. No more guessing. According to TikTok, they recommend videos based on a combination of a couple things. First is user interaction. This means the videos that you engage with, the accounts that you choose to follow, and also the content that you yourself create. Next up, we have video information. This includes things like the caption, the sound, and the hashtags included. And lastly, device and account settings, the type of phone you use, the country you're in, and your language. Here's a little secret though. Everyone gets on someone's For You page, but it's a matter of how many other For You pages you get on. The amount of FYPs you get on depends on how people interact with your video. When you press post, TikTok shares your video to a small batch of users on their FYP and bases the success on the following factors: watch time, rewatches, shares, comments, likes. It's important to note that watch time, rewatches, and shares are weighted more heavily than comments and likes. If your video performs well with that initial batch, TikTok will then allow your video to progress, congratulations, to the next stage, which is a larger audience. Each time your video progresses, the audience it's shown to you widens and widens each time, and therefore your video has a longer lifetime due to being shown to more and more For You pages. The amazing thing is, videos on TikTok can have a really long lifespan. That means that content that you see on the FYP could be days, weeks, or even months old. This is great to keep in mind because it shows you that your videos, despite maybe being posted a month ago, can still have the opportunity to gain traction and heck, even go viral. Let's go over some quick tips to ensure that you appear on more and more For You pages and therefore extend the lifespan of your video. Some of which are things that we've talked about already and some are some new things. So first, have a niche and create content for your ideal client or follower. TikTok will get to know the type of content that you create and then show it to the right people. Implement a hook every time, really grab people's attention so that they continue to watch your video. It is crucial. Of course, you always want to have some sort of CTA, and if you ask people to comment, that means not only are you getting that engagement, but your video will play in the background as they comment, aka a higher rewatch rate. Keep your video short to encourage a higher watch time and that rewatch rate. When you post your video, always be the first to comment in your comment section and use it as an opportunity to ask a question. This encourages others to comment and gives them an easy way to engage with you. Create shareable content. My high performing videos all have something in common, and it's that they have a high amount of shares. When someone shares your video, that tells TikTok that your content is so good that it's a must watch for other people as well. Tap into trends, but make them on brand and put your own unique twist on them. Also play around with trending sounds as well to get a little bit of a boost, and create videos that build up anticipation and encourage the viewer to keep watching till the end to get more information, to reach a resolution, or to get to the punchline. And here's an advanced tip for you. Play around with looped videos. This means that there is not a clear beginning and an end to the video, so that when the video ends, it actually seamlessly feeds into the beginning and the person will keep watching without realizing right away that the video started again. But after all of this work, in attempt to create a video so good that it stays on the FYP, how can you actually tell that you've landed on lots of people's For You pages? Two ways. First, in real time, head to your notifications feed and make sure likes are selected. Scroll until you see a like notification that has two circles and something like username 123, username XYZ, and six others. Click on that and it will bring you to a new page that shows a small freeze frame of your video in a small rectangle at the top and also a feed of the people who have liked your video. If you look to the right, there will be a red button next to each username, and it will either say follow or follow back. If the bulk of the likes say follow back, then your video hasn't hit many people's For You page yet. If you're seeing lots of follows stacked on top of each other, that means people who don't follow you are seeing your video and liking it, and therefore you have hit lots of people's For You page. The second way is to check after at least 24 hours. Make sure you have a TikTok Pro account. It's free so that you can access your analytics. And when looking at your analytics, head to the content tab and then click on one of your most recent videos. The next screen will show your traffic source types. And from here, you can see the percentage of views that came from being on the FYP. Last tip about the For You page. If you realize that your video is being shown to lots of people's For You page in real time, go live. Though heads up, you do need at least 1,000 followers to go live. This is great to grab the attention of all of these new potential followers and potentially hook them in, and to also build relationships with the new people who just started following you because of this viral video. On that note, let's chat about going viral. So let's set the stage. You have created a content strategy. You're posting consistently. Maybe you've even started to see your views increase. But what about the thing that everyone talks about, going viral? Well, first, what does it even mean to go viral? Let's chat about that. It depends. If you're used to getting 50 to 100 views a video and then break 10K, that for you is totally viral. If you're used to getting 50K to 100K views and breaking the million mark may feel viral. But regardless of whatever that threshold is for you, I want to make something very clear. Going viral is certainly fun, there's no doubt about that, but going viral should not be the goal. Instead, what should be the goal? Consistent value. Allow me to explain myself. Your profile should act as a portfolio of your work. Your videos should fit within your niche, and your topics should speak directly to your ideal client or follower. Your videos should motivate, educate, or entertain, and aim to lead with impact and value so people want to follow you because they will benefit from doing so. Fill up your profile with these types of videos. This is crucial because once one of your videos goes viral, you have a plethora of content to back it up. The significance is not of a viral video itself, but the outcome of that viral video. If you post a random video that has nothing to do with what you normally talk about and it goes viral, and then someone clicks through to your feed in the hopes of finding more similar content, they'll probably be a little disappointed and they're not gonna follow you. Let's say you post a video that goes viral and you have an incohesive feed of random videos that have no common theme. The same thing is gonna happen here. Someone may, you know, browse your profile for a moment, but then realize that there's nothing there for them and move on. However, let's think about the following scenario. You are a social media coach and you focus on Instagram and you post all kinds of social media tips to help people build their online presence and grow their audience on that platform. You post a video about how to grow to 10K followers and it goes viral. If someone is watching that video, they're interested in it, they like it, and they go to your page to see what else you're about, they are going to find a gold mine of lots of other videos that are all about Instagram. Because of this, they are way more likely to follow you. So no, the goal is not to go viral. The goal should be to create a wealth of content that is on brand and valuable so that when you do go viral, it can lead to meaningful follows, which then lead to holding their attention, which lead to trust and building connection. Let's talk about growth. The opportunity for growth on TikTok is cuckoo bananas. It's truly unlike any other platform out there due to the potential for so much organic visibility thanks to the algorithm behind the For You page. But just because it's like this right now does not mean it's gonna be this way forever. So I recommend jumping on this platform ASAP and taking advantage of what's currently possible today. There's no magical secret to growth, but there are some intentional strategies that you can absolutely put in place, some of which we've discussed already. So let's go over them to make sure they're in the noggin. Creating valuable videos with hooks and CTAs. Creating shorter videos around the 15-second mark. Experimenting with trends and trending sounds. Creating thumbnails with enticing titles to display on your page. Let's also chat about a few things that we have yet to talk about yet. Hashtags. Hashtags function in two ways on TikTok. One, discoverability. If you use hashtags on your video, then your video will appear under that specific hashtag when someone else searches for it. Two, categorization. By using hashtags like hashtag makeup tutorial, this tells TikTok what the video is about. This helps to then show your video to the people who are interested in that specific topic. It's best to use about 3 to 5 hashtags per post, no more than that. Next, post consistently. Now, you'll probably hear from lots of people to post as much as possible. Some people even say to post 10 to 20 times a day. Ooh, that is a lot. There is no possible way you're posting quality videos at that speed. So you have to find what works for you. I would say post at minimum once a day, and if you can get up to 3 times a day, that's fabulous. But also keep value in mind. I would say it's better to post more quality rather than quantity. Think about your username and if you can include your niche within it. For example, at Maria Smith Makeup Tutorials or at Dan Jacobs TikTok Tips. When people search these keywords, there's a chance that your account name will pop up. Make sure that you turn all of your post settings on. So when you're on the page where you write your captions and your hashtags before posting, make sure that your video is set to public, the comments are allowed, and that duets are allowed, and that your video can be saved to device. Next, don't delete your videos ever. TikTok doesn't like this. Just set them to private instead. Keep an eye on your analytics to see what performs the best, gets on the For You page the most, and gets the most shares. Then recreate that content. Engage with your audience. Like and respond back to their comments. Make videos answering their questions and go live to interact with them. Holy smokes, y'all, we just covered a lot of content. Everything from content strategy to video creation, the For You page, going viral, and growing on TikTok. I hope you guys learned a whole bunch, and I truly hope that this motivates you to just dive in, take some messy action with this platform to create, connect, show up, and serve valuable content. I super duper appreciate you taking the time to join, listen, and learn. Feel free to find me on Instagram and of course TikTok. My handle is JeraBean, but there's a dot in the middle, so it's Jera.Bean. And I would love to hear from you. Send me a DM with your biggest takeaway from the TikTok lesson. All right, cutie patooties, I will see you soon. Have a good one. Mwah. Bye.